everybody. This is Christine Bertram and...
Hello, Kelly!
We're here live from the Hive in the Cards by Christine studio, and we're here today to go through a Tip Tuesday with you. Isn't this weird? You're seeing both of our faces. Well, Kelly, I think you guys know, has been doing the Tip Tuesdays since September, and you guys have been loving them.
So have I.
They have been awesome. I even love watching them because it helps me remember different things that I should do.
And you guys, keep commenting. Mm-hmm. Oftentimes I'm saying, hey, this is the tip. And then if you look in the comments, people have like additional tips or like things.
Yes. So
I mean, I'm learning. She's learning. We're all learning.
Yes. For example, that just happened with Kelly's tip from the other day with the permanent, so the stays-on ink pad with the memento. Jean Maxwell commented that she puts dimensionals on top of that clear plastic cover, and then it sticks to the cover, so then you're not having to lift both covers. Like, that was awesome, Jean. So you guys, when you know more than us, do not be afraid just to say it. We know a lot, but we don't know everything. And what we try to do is share as much of what we know with you to help make your crafting experience better. So sometimes we don't know it all. A lot of the times I don't think we know it all. Or we get confused. So always add those comments. Just like Kelly said, it really helps everybody else too to learn more. And it's better when we can all inspire and create together. So I promised Kelly that after the winter creative escape was done, that I would get on the horn with her to do the Tip Tuesdays and Technique Thursdays so that it was more of a cohesive synergy between the two of us. And so sometimes I may do the live and sometimes she may do the, it's not a live, haha, the Tip Tuesday or the Technique Thursday. So it has been asked for many, many times for for a specific video on how to make bows. So I always am making bows in my lives. I love making bows only because of the bow maker. Some people refer to it as a bow jig, but regardless, it makes beautiful bows if you know how to use it properly. And I make lots of bows in the lives on Thursday nights, but you don't want to have to look for that. It's like a pain in the butt. So we're going to have a specific video, this one in fact, on how to make bows. So Kelly's just going to make sure that this is being recorded so that we don't have to start over. She's going to check that while I get started, and I'm going to flip my camera down. So if you guys recall, a couple Tuesdays, it might have been like two Tuesdays ago, she had all my beautiful paper snips that she took to her house to do the videos. And it's always important that you use your ribbon scissors when you're cutting ribbon. Oh, Kelly, we need ribbon.
Yep,
it's in the bucket. So you definitely don't want to use your glue or your paper for this endeavor. You will not be happy with your frayed edges. So we're like, okay, well, what ribbons do we want to use? So we are in the thick of the mini catalog, the mini January through June catalog. And we have beautiful ribbons and beautiful twine. Oh my gosh. So we're like, well, let's use something that's in the mini catalog because all of this makes different ribbons. Okay, and now that we're seeing this right here, you're like, well, this is defective. No, it's not defective. If you ever get a roll of ribbon from Stampin' Up! And there is a piecemeal of it together, that means that it got to the end of the spool or the master ribbon contraption, and they taped it together to keep going. So hopefully that never conflicts with what project you're working on, because like right now, this is the perfect length for us to make a bow, and so that's what we're going to use. But if you ever get that, you don't have to worry about that. That just means that you got lucky with the end. That's how you gotta look at it. So, but look at all these pretty ribbons. So I'm gonna show you how to make different bows. So like, for example, this is one of the cards that's coming up in the February monthly class with the succulents. And it has on here the Blackberry Bliss striped like organdy ribbon. So it's kind of sheer. Okay, so in your bow maker, everybody's are maybe a little different, but I do have these. I get these from a friend whose friend's husband makes them. It's down the road, the link there. But I do have them for sale. They're $5 plus shipping. And they come with two nails. Whoa. They come with two nails. And there's holes on the side for you to store them. You do have to be careful because if you have this in your toolbox, you know, it could come loose and be hanging out in your in the bottom of your toolbox. Just know that not all bow makers have a storage spot for the nails. So sometimes you just need to store them in a plastic bag. And the measurements. You know, I don't always know if your measurements are going to be the same as everybody else's, but like this is set up that this is about 1¼ inches. Like this one is 2¼ and then 3¼. But you could also go with this nail and that nail, which makes it 1½. You could go with that one to that one, 2½. So you can make the size bow, and you know, until you're working on your project, you may not know what size bow you want. So having the bow maker allows you to temporarily make a bow and see if it's the right size before you actually go to finish it. And I can show you that. So what you want to do though, I'm a right-handed person. So I like to take the loose end of the ribbon in my right hand and with the bow maker flat. So here's another thing. Some people take and put like a tape or their adhesive eraser and put it underneath the bow maker so that it stays set. You just gotta be careful. You could put little gripper feet on the bottom to help it hold it, but as long as you're not, you know, crazy with it, it shouldn't go all over your desk. But I'm right-handed, so I like to take the loose end in my right hand. I don't like to cut myself a piece because I might waste ribbon. And if you guys have been watching, I don't like to waste ribbon. I'm a ribbon conserver and I'm a paper conserver. So I leave this attached until I go to cut it off. So with my right hand, I take the loose end and I go underneath the attached piece. And it's very important when you're crossing these that you have it smooth like this, because when it's smooth like that, it's not gonna be all bunchy. So like if you've got it like that, and I don't know if you guys can see that, it just, you want it to be nice and smooth. And so now you have your loose end on the left side. You go up and over. Now just keep in mind that this is the front, even though it's not to me right now. This makes the front of your bow. So it's very important that this right here is smooth, not like twisted like that. So when it's smooth like that, then you go under. And now you're on the back side again. So this is, in essence, the back of your bow, and you're gonna tie it into a knot. So I take the left side, and I bring it over. The loose end is now on the right. I go under, up. This is the most important part of the whole process, your tails. How you pull your tails is how your bow is going to go. Do you want it wonky? Then just pull your tails and pull them however you want. But if you want your tails nice and pristine and straight down, while you're tightening this knot, you go down and to the left and to the right and tighten as you pull your tails. I'm pulling them down and to the left and the right, okay? So it might help if you have a little higher on the jig, but pulling that. So watch this now. Now look at this little guy right here. We're gonna cut that off and you're never gonna know that it was a waste. Look at that, boom, he's out of here. Okay, so now you've got a beautiful bow made on your bow maker. I pull out the nails one at a time, and I then am amazed at how cute it is. Mm-hmm. So here's this little teeny tiny baby bow. All right, so now you can see my tails go down until, you know, that was perfect. If you find that they are still going to the left and the right, it is no problem. All you do is when you're putting your bow on your card, you're gonna put a glue dot. You never use liquid glue. No, like bad. Never liquid glue with a fabric. It's just, it's gonna make a hot, sticky mess for you and you're not gonna be happy. You may cry even. So we don't need that. No crying and stamping. So you use a glue dot. So what you do is put this right into there. Now, if your tails are going like all over the place, and even if they're not going all over the place, I generally show it who's boss. So I will put that, and you know, it looks good, but when you put it in the mail and in the envelope, it might be all over the place by the time your person gets it. So I would generally put a glue dot underneath each tail just to make it look perfect. And then after I've got it secured where I want, that's when I take and I trim off. So it's really crazy, but I do get a lot of cards with the ends of bows cut like that. And everything is always a personal preference, you guys. It really is. So if you like your ends cut like that, you go for it. But generally when you cut ribbons ends, you cut them like so that they're at a diagonal and it just finishes the bow like that. And you could do your bows, you know, your ends this way, you know, the opposite of what I just did it too, and that looks nice too. It just depends how your bow is laying. So now you've got your bow on here and it's all nice and secure. Cutesy little baby bow. Now what happens though, you've seen me make like double bunny ears is what I would call them. So a double bunny ear is, you can, okay, so that size bow, you know, this bow right here, you can make that with your nails wherever you want them. To make the double bow though, you just wrap your ribbon around an extra time. So here was a single bow one time, and now if you wanna do a double bow, you bring it around again. So now you're gonna end up with two bunny ears on each side. Now when you do a double bunny, it's sometimes like it's hard to do a little baby bow with lots of little bunny ears. It just gets to be, I don't think, and it's just, it might not look so good. So if you're gonna do a double, you might just do it a little bit bigger of a bow like that, and I'll show you here. So now again, you've got your loose side on your right, and I generally have this about a good inch and a half past the block to allow for enough finagling around and over and under. So the right side under, making sure you're nice and smooth here. You go over the horn and under, and then you end with your two ends in the back, and then the left side goes over, under, and then again, the master at the end here, the masterpiece, what makes it so amazing is how your tails go. So you see, I had to kind of finagle that tail to go where I wanted. Now that I got it, as I tight, I am pulling out to the left and to the right and downward, okay? So then you can trim off where you want it. Then take your nails out, and now this is what you have. You've got a bunny ear here, a bunny ear, and then now these are completely on top of each other. What you would do is just pull one of them out. See if you can get, oh man, it's right there. I gotta get it. There. Okay, pull that out, because then you can see how awesome that double looks. So let's go on top of the white. There, you might see that better. Okay, so that's like the double. Then you could go as far as a triple. I mean, honestly, the sky's the limit with the bows, but you go one, two, and then three. So when you do, now I had mentioned that, well, you might not know if that size bow is what you want. So you see how I'm really short here for a ribbon? That's not gonna be enough to tie it. So you can start to see that. So what you do is just give yourself a little bit more ribbon like that. And there, you got to have enough ribbon here to go under, and then back here, tie a knot. So I wanna see like, well, what size does, okay, so that looks like it's too thick. It should have been a little bit bigger of a bow. So to do the three bunny ears. But this is where I was saying earlier, like you could say, oh, well, what size bow do I want? You could kind of hold it over here and be like, oh, okay, that looks good, and then go for it. Or you'd be like, nope, I need a little bit bigger bow, and then you could adjust this accordingly. There's one more knack or hack or trick. You sometimes will get double-sided ribbon. Do you see this really pretty blushing bride on one side and this golden crumb cake on the other side? I don't know if it's more goldy or crumb cake, but it's a metallic, sheery, I don't know. It's just pretty. So it's double-sided though. So what happens when you go to make a bow? Okay, so here's, I'm not gonna tie it quite, but I'm gonna show you. So you're gonna go around and make a double here. And you go my process, and then, oh man, you've got the gold now, and then you've got the pink in the middle. Well, that looks cool if that's what you're going for. That would be awesome. But like, let's say you don't want that pink there. It's important on the back side here to have it twisted slightly. So I just twisted it ever so slightly, which will allow me to have that gold on the top back there, and then bring that through. And now you've got both, you know, the bow, the bunny ears and the middle are the golden. But now how do you tie it? That's the trickery. Because right now you have gold on this side and you have blushing bride on that side. Well, that's not gonna work so good. So you kind of gotta twist this one too. Now when you tie this, this is so important. Remembering that the front is the gold, this is what's gonna make all the difference, is how you tighten your knot back here. So as I was talking, I was finagling my ribbon so that the gold was on the front on both sides. And now as I go to tighten it, my tails should be gold, gold, and then I'd have the pink on the back. So that's, it's just gonna take a little bit for you guys to practice. I'm not going to keep this one. I only have this much ribbon of this guy left and I got to conserve it. So, but I wanted to show you, there's a really pretty ribbon in the annual catalog. I'm pretty sure that it's still current. Let's go over our ribbons real quick. If you guys want to see some of our awesome ribbons on page 150, oh, it's actually 161. There is a really pretty reversible ribbon, Old Olive with Purity Peacock. So this kind of ribbon would have the same kind of thing happen if you're trying to make a bow. It's the only other one that might not work so good unless you know how to get everything straightened out. So there's just a little example of the reversing. So what else did we want to go over, Kelly? So
I think that was it. You guys, it's the ribbon video. This is it.
I think we started doing lives in March of last year, right? So almost a year. And I have to say, honestly, when you guys started seeing me making bows with the bow maker, it was like, we need bow makers, but now we need to know how to make them. But now I don't remember. I saw you do it one time, but I don't remember. And I would have people in class taking videos on their phone so that they could go home. I shouldn't laugh, but that's exactly what I would do, is make it in class and they would take a video on their phone so that when they went home, they would have it. Well, so here's your official video on how to do bows and how we did single bunny ears, double bunny ears, triple bunny ears, different sizes, and how to work with the reversible ribbon and how to cut your ends and put them on your card. Okay. So I am so excited because you guys are going to start whipping out some pretty fabulous bows. I know it. And I'm going to see them when you show me pictures of your cards. So, okay. Well, this was our first Tip Tuesday together. We kind of tag teamed it just to make sure it was successful. It was the first one in the Hive. And technically it's live now in the Hive, but it won't be live for you because we are planning to do get together like twice a month and make 2 weeks worth of videos so that Kelly is not up at midnight working on videos for us. So, all right, with that, you guys, I hope you guys have a great rest of your week and make something pretty spectacular. Bye.
Bye.